economy. That's why the economic reforms are initiated to create an accountability. Because of these economic reforms, what is one of the important irrigation of them? Without any responsibility, all the people, top industries in the country, politicians, nexus relationship with the politicians and the education and the judiciary also, I'm sorry to comment on the judiciary, even though nexus relation has developed, as a result, 10 years non-performing assets, the growth rate abnormal increase. So this is one of the challenge for the Indian economic post-reforms. This is a great challenge. Simultaneously, another important challenge, how do we prepare our human resources? Today, human resources is going to an important growth, come down to 1.2, 1.3.
I am greatly honored to introduce the Chief Guest of presenting a few of his academic and administrative achievements. He hails from Veeramani of Kadama district. Regarding his academic background, we will catapult him to the Zenith in the education form.
And globalized by oil refining activities. If you are starting afresh, now government says we are
here. The 30 years of the academic knowledge gathered and the magnum.
At that juncture, P.V. Narasimha Rao became the Prime Minister of India, who was a very good scholar and who was known to be more not only politician, from academic aspect, he was the person who was having the knowledge of Indian economy. Lot of support was given by the governments to the economy in different ways. But I do not know what happened. Though support was given, the economy was not healthy. Whatever the benefits given by the government in terms of different names, it was not utilized properly by the concerned sector like industry, commerce, trade, whatever it is. Our industry or other sectors playing important role in the economic development not upgraded themselves technologically. By that time, the other world was going somewhere, but in India, not able to think of technology upgradation. Thereby, the effect was there. Quality consciousness, even it is relevant at any point of time. You take the quality of anything in India, either products or services. Even today there is a question mark. Not able to render quality service and quality goods. Quality consciousness has not been inculcated either by the producers or by the consumers, both. Lot of gap is there. Historical necessity for the government of India to do something in the economic sector to bring it to the line. Therefore, lot of economic reforms came into existence. These reforms can be categorized broadly into three perspectives as far as my knowledge goes: globalization, liberalization, privatization. Since 1991, these three concepts have become very, very popular. But what we have to keep in mind is here, when our economy was opened, when our economy became liberalized, when we tried to increase the role of private sector, whether the environment is conducive to take place, that is the question I have in my mind. For anything to happen in the expected manner, we have to create an environment to play. So that was my feeling. One side there was no option, on the other side there was no preparedness or ground to go forward as per these concepts. So as a result, what happened? Still today we are facing problems only. On one side we can say, showing some figures, that we have been developed. But on the other side, there are so many indicators showing that still we are not developed. So this kind of, you know, paradoxical situation is going on since 1991. This is my observation. Some of the human development indicators I can show. If you say that these reforms have yielded results, on the other side we should see the development indicators. Yesterday somewhere I have seen one of the human development indicators where India was 129th place. Exactly. So if you say any human development indicator, even today we are in the last, we are at the bottom of the total countries in the world. In my view, there are, you know, the countries like, you know, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh are better in some parameters than India. But, you know, we say proudly, lot of things have taken place in India doing wonders. So being part of the, you know, government, I would not be able to see. So it's a kind of, you know, paradoxical situation. On one side, arguments are there saying that something happened, something happened, something happened. On the other side, if you see, nothing. So this is the, you know, paradoxical situation. In reality, you could not feel. Unemployment is increasing. Even today, health is not accessible to crores of people. Education is not accessible. Living standards are not increased. Even today people are suffering for food, hunger. So there is something, you know, wrong in the system whole, as a whole. What I am also trying to understand, there is no, you know, proper organic link between the political system and the economic system. In India, first of all, the perspective of the political system should change, because in any country, political system is the system that will influence the other systems, because political system governs the countries.
You can see the role of always that the people as the consumers only.
Problems is always touching one of the important the point. Businessmen became a legislators. This is an alarming bell to the Indian economy compared to the before 91, after 91 scenario might be different. Crony capitalism is taking place in India. That is the reason. Another important the point, lacks of the human resources came from the initiations with technical degrees, professional degrees, but employability is very less. Skill gap prevail if the government has initiated so many skill programs. Is need to think about it. Another important point the Bhaskar Garu has touched, basic amenities is concerned. As a civil servant and with the different capacities, definitely observe and has given a solution to also various basic problems of the society which has suffered and faced by the common man in India. Still, potable drinking water is not actually used by the so many people. Very recently I saw more than 45 crore people still today facing severe acute of the potable drinking water. Still today, more than 10 crore people didn't have electricity in India. These are the very important points. Health is concerned also, sir, mentioned. These also, the future researchers may take into account and do some work on this for the sake of the betterment of this country. And NPS, because of the crony capitalism, people, especially intelligence, the crony capitalist, put a cap on the commercial banks. More than 7 lakhs of the crores rupees, completely the people waived, and some of the people left this country also. So many type of the problems actually mount up. The people completely waive the loans and cross this country. So many scams, Lalit Modi and so many people. Sir, really this is very, very important point, a discussable point. Definitely the Department of the Commerce and Business Administration and Faculty of the Commerce and Management study definitely taken into account. And our keynote speaker also put forward some of the issues. All these things will take into account it in the future research.
Madam,
request our chief guest is felicitating the Professor Lakshmi Patrath Garu, today the keynote speaker of the
NR. To honor our President of this occasion,
sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Especially Dr. Venkatesh Ragar, this comment of the dais, and present the quote of the thanks.
At outset,
thanks, sir.
Sir, you tested several items. Thank you, sir. Thank you, thank you, Rinal.
Nice.